everyone, and welcome to UCA News. I'm Arub.
And I'm Delilah. Arub is one of our new anchors.
Yes, she is. Welcome, Arub. Oh, and I'm Yesenia.
You may be wondering what UCA News is.
UCA News is a weekly broadcast made for UCA students by UCA students.
We premiere our episodes every Monday during announcements and post them on our website.
You can find this week's episode of the news at uca.school/news.
For today's announcements, here are a few upcoming events. To start, there will be a hobby expo, Thursday, February 3rd at 3 p.m.
It will be so fun, so come and join us and see the incredible different hobbies out there.
And speaking of hobbies, let's send it out to Austin for a segment for all the fans of Tiny Toy Bricks.
Hey guys, it's Austin from Let's Go Legos with Austin. And today I'm going to be talking about the brick remover. Right here. It has multiple purposes, but I'm going to be showing you one of them. Let's get to it. But before we do, let's get some word from my little friend, Tony.
Thank you, Austin. Hello, guys, kids of UCA. I'm here to talk about some more info about the brick remover. You may say, hey, what is the reason of the brick remover? Well, there's more reasons to it. Austin, back to you.
Thank you, Tony. Now let's get to it. Okay, here we go. As you can see, I have some bricks in the wrong spot. I'm going to be trying the blade first, and then, no, it's not sharp, so it's made so people don't get cut. So we're going to start. You can stick it in here or on the side. Oh no, it won't work. Now, we're going to try this end. Here we go. You stick it like so. On the piece. I'm only doing this one-handed. Let's do the black piece right here. You put it on and then pop it back, pull it back, and there we go. Takes the brick off. That's why it's got name of the brick remover. This piece is to pop out Technic bricks, but I don't have any with me right now. I do have them, but not right now. Maybe in another video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode. Bye. And remember, be cheerful.
That was awesome, Austin. But I'm ready to know some interesting facts about the world. Take it away, Piper.
The biggest pizza ever created was 13,580 square feet, created in Rome, Italy.
Very interesting fact, Piper. However, let's investigate a little more with UCA Investigates.
I'm Emma Vore. I'm a senior at Utah Connections Academy, and I also take two concurrent enrollment classes at Salt Lake Community College. For next semester, I'm taking English 2010 and then, 1020. And physics 1010.
Awesome. And by the time you graduate from high school, how many concurrent enrollment credits will you have?
I'll have 12.
What are your plans after high school? Is it to continue at the community college or transfer to another school?
I'm going to transfer them to Weber State.
So welcome. Thank you for joining us in this interview, Emma and Ms. Hansen. We just have a few questions about concurrent enrollment. Our first one would be, what schools can you attend with concurrent enrollment?
That's a great question. And with our school, we are contracted with Dixie State University, whatever their new name is. I don't remember off the top of my head. Snow College and Salt Lake Community College. So if there's another student or another school that students want to work with, we can make arrangements with them, but we don't have a current contract, which is where, you know, we're set up in their system and we have advisors that we work with through that school. But those are the three that we have contracts set up with.
So how many credits do you get per class?
So you get 3 credits per class per semester.
3 credits per class per semester.
Yep.
Cool.
So how many credits do you need to count for finishing a class or a semester?
So it depends on if you want a scholarship for taking concurrent enrollment. So usually you have to take 12 credits for 2 semesters to get a scholarship, but most advisors recommend not taking 3 college classes per semester just because you'll feel overloaded.
All right.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
What's it like doing the courses? Are they hard or are they like the other high school courses you have? Time consuming? What's it like?
So, I mean, it's a college class, so it's a bit harder, but it's definitely the same type of format as a high school class. Like, you still get the same help from the teachers and the students feel the same. It's very, very similar.
Good to know.
Yeah.
So what do you recommend to not fall behind in concurrent enrollment?
So I recommend definitely checking your email every day, because sometimes professors will just like post something without telling you, and you just have to make sure you're always checking. And if you're doing it through Canvas, always look at your planner and just always be checking.
Well,
how do you organize all your classes, especially with concurrent enrollment?
So I have a planner and I just write down all the stuff I'm going to do for the day. And usually I start with just my Utah Connections Academy classes. And then I start doing my concurrent enrollment.
Nice.
Yeah.
So when you do college classes, if you fail, does it stay on your record?
It does, but you can retake that class, and when you retake that class and get a passing grade, it will count towards your credits. So you definitely want to make sure you're doing your best and organizing your time, like Emma mentioned, because if you have to retake that class, it takes time and it takes money as well. So you have to pay to retake that class. So, but there are options. Things do come up during a semester that, you know, might prevent you from finishing, but you know, it's just always best to try and finish and get that passing grade the first time.
Well, thank you for joining us. Those are amazing answers. Very helpful to all the students who might want to take concurrent enrollment their following years in high school.
Yeah.
See what the science club prepared.
Hey, are you interested in science and can't find anything else to satisfy your science needs? Join the science club. Each month, the science club will talk about awesome topics and do experiments together. The science club is unique in so many ways. One of the ways is we will use Flipgrid to show our experiments step by step, or the solution to that month's topic. The grade levels for the club are 1 through 12. The meetings will be on Thursdays each month, once a month. You can sign up today by going to uca.school/science club. I'll see you there.
Thank you for that information. Anyone interested in science, we recommend you go to their first meeting February 10th.
Next up, we have a special presentation for our new students about our website.
Welcome to Utah Connections Academy. I'm your presenter, Sam Abernathy. This presentation was made by Kate and Sherry Cornwall of the Utah Connections Academy news crew. And I'll be here to teach you tips to help you with school. Here's how to access our UCA website. You can go to your teacher's webmail, or you can go to the icon section of your main page underneath the teacher's signature. An easy way to access the website is to type in uca.school. This is for the whole school website. And when it comes to up to save it to your bookmarks. The way to access your specific teacher's website is to click the grade band K through 6, or 7 to 12. This will bring up all your teachers and their website and contact information. Their website can be found under their name. The website will be the Blue World. Once you click it on the Blue World, you'll find all you need. And also, you can find a BookMe site. Those are really helpful when you need help and it's not web in and out time. Please use them, and this will help you a lot during your time here at UCA. Now,
our website is an awesome resource that everyone should check out.
Yes, that's right. But before we go, we have a very, very special segment. Take it away, Mr. G.
I just cannot get my students to remember the moon phases, and I don't know what to do. Hey, this kind of looks like him. I've got it!
It goes, new moon, waxing crescent, first quarter, waxing gibbous, full moon, waning gibbous, third quarter, waning crescent, those are the phases of the moon, those are the phases of the moon, those are the phases of the moon, those are the phases,
Alright, that was the first edition of Teachers Teach with TikTok. I'm throwing out a challenge to anyone, and I mean anyone, in high school math that thinks that they can top that video. Let's see what you got.
Shout out to Mr. G, who volunteered to go first. And let's not forget to mention his awesome dance moves.
Yeah, go Mr. G. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed another episode of the news as much as we did to make it.
Until next time, hope you have a nice week. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.